Don't Eat All the Shellfish. Mark McEwen, Naturapl by Ellen Woodward. Humans aren't the only primate to have pushed their prey towards extinction. Monkeys have also overexploited animals for food. Long-tailed macaques forage for shellfish on islands off Thailand, then crack them open with stone tools. They target the largest rock oysters, bludgeoning them with stone hammers, and pry open the meatiest snail and crab shells with the flattened edges of their tools. These macaques are one of three primates that use stone tools, alongside chimpanzees in Africa and bearded capuchins in South America. Stone tools open up an opportunity for foods they otherwise wouldn't even be able to harvest, says Lydia Lunch at the University of Oxford. Advertisement Lunch wanted to investigate the impact of the monkeys' shellfish snacking on the prey themselves. Her team followed 18 macaques on their daily foraging routes along the shores of Koh Samui Nam Sao, two neighboring islands off eastern Thailand, recording their tool selection and use. On Koh Samui, the more densely populated island, home to 80 macaques compared with Nam Sao's 9, Lunch's group saw not only smaller oysters and snails, but also fewer of each species. Multiple prey species were less abundant on Koh Samui than Nam Sao, with four times as many tropical periwinkles on Nam Sao as on Koh Samui. LF.doi.org/cc7d. It's been shown that systematic predation causes prey of smaller size, says Nathaniel Domini at Dartmouth College in Hanover, New Hampshire. The oysters on Koh Samui were about 70% smaller than their counterparts on Nam Sao, and the periwinkles were less than half the size. A single tool-using monkey on Koh Samui can eat over 40 shellfish a day, so Lunch's group thinks this predation pressure is driving these shellfish changes. Lunch says the macaques might deplete the prey on the islands. Afterwards, they will stop using stone tools and even forget how. Tool use, a socially learned behavior, has always been viewed as this positive thing that opens up resources, she says. But by overharvesting, they're putting their technology knowledge at risk. What's more, Domini thinks the study might help us better understand modern humans' exit from Africa over 70,000 years ago. One idea is that our ancestors didn't travel overland, but instead followed the Asian coastline, relying on shellfish for food. Over time, we see a reduction in shell size in the archaeological record, which suggests a systematic use of shellfish, Domini says. But nobody was sure whether size reduction was due to changing ocean conditions or larger-scale human predation. This paper is the first to offer compelling evidence in support of the former, he says. This article appeared in print under the headline "Tool-using Monkeys Suck Shellfish Dry." More on these topics.